Lawler across the ring, staggers the champion. A big knee drops, picks Lawler up high and drops him hard. And this could be the pin. A two count. A two count. One more would have given Fuller the title. Lawler is picked up, whipped into the ropes, met with a back.
GWH TV, bringing you classic wrestling action sanctioned by the Georgia Wrestling History Network.
All right, and welcome to another sure to be riveting episode of GWH TV on the GWH, the Wrestling History Network for Georgia and the Southeast. I am your co-host, John Stoney Cannon. And with me, Big Stevie Jay.
That's me.
That's him. And we are here once again to take you back in time for some great, awesome wrestling history. Georgia, Carolinas, Tennessee, Florida, Alabama. Everything having to do with the South. And this is brought to you, like I said earlier, by Georgia Wrestling History.
And we don't even need a DeLorean to do it.
Nope.
We just need all this. So,
that's it. And we got a great show for you. Later on in the broadcast, we will have a little bit of VPW update from who?
My brother, Kenny.
Kenny!
He's back from his little... He wanted to take a little break. He's back today.
That's right.
Probably next week, too. So
we got a great stuff for you. Some stuff from CWA Memphis. And, of course, from Georgia Championship Wrestling. But as every show, every event has to start off with the opening bell, we are going to take you to, speaking of CWA Memphis, that's Championship Wrestling in Memphis, we're going to take you to this match from March 8, 1986.
And it's a pretty fantastic match, if I'd have to say so myself.
Pretty fantastic, speaking of which, the Fantastics, and they'll be taking on the duo of Tony Falk and Keith Eric, not to be confused with that Columbo Falk guy. And I think this is going to end up being not only a pretty fantastic match, but a pretty fucking good match.
Falcon right.
Yep, so Falcon A, are you guys ready to get right the Falk to this match?
I am fantastically ready for that.
All right.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Falk off!
The Championship Wrestling is the championship cheerleading squad in the girls' division. They were the national champs, won it in Florida a couple of weeks or so ago from Bartlett High School in Memphis, Tennessee. And they are the guests of Championship Wrestling up here today. Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, their favorites of all of them.
Titles around their waist. This is a non-title match. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Introducing at a total of 432 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Keith Eric, and from St. Louis, Missouri, Tony Falk, going against them at a total of 449 pounds from the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California, Bobby Fulton, Tommy Rogers, the Fantastic.
Don't start the match.
Jerry, hold on. Hold it, referee.
You better get back there. I don't think you're ready to be out of here.
Vance, I don't know what I'm going to do. Oh, God.
We can talk about it later, Jerry. You don't need to do it right now. I mean, hey, you did whatever you could.
Listen.
Savage guys come out here and start going after the eyes. That's the important thing. Let's worry about that now. Jeff is okay. He's going to be all right. Let's go. Okay.
All right.
Yeah, let's go on with the match, okay? All right. All right, referee Jerry Calhoun up there. We're going to go on. All right, bell sounds, and here we go. The Fantastics going against Tony Falk and Keith Eric. That's Bobby Fulton in there. Hold on. Hold on. Hold it. Hold it just a minute, referee. Hold it. Can we stop just for a minute? Eddie Marlin.
I want to tell you something. Jerry Jarrett's been in my family for a long time. He's a leader. He knows what to do in any circumstances. This is the first time that I've ever seen him in this situation. They tried to put out his one good eye. When he got his eye put out, he didn't cry about it. He didn't tell very few people, but I knew about it. They beat up my grandson. They put him out. Jerry don't know what to do, but I know what to do. He's the leader, and when he's around, I'll say, what do you want to do, Jerry? And he'll tell me. But he's not here to tell me now, and I know what to do. It's one man that I know of that I can put in there with Dutch Mantell, and they can take care of those two guys. And that one man is Jerry Lawler. I don't care about the contract, Bill Dundee. You can sue me. You can sue the company. You can put us out of business. But Jerry Lawler, I'm going to go get him on the phone right now. And if I can get Jerry Lawler to come here, he will be against Dundee and Landell. Now, I'm going to call him on the phone, and if I can get him, he will be here.
Contract or no contract, Eddie's going to try to get him. We'll bring you up to date on that. All right, the match is underway again. Restarting here, and the Fantastic going after him. Keith Eric takes the double drop kick as the Fantastic put him down. Tony Falk has just rolled out of the ring. Tommy Rogers going against Keith Eric. Boy, what an announcement by Eddie Marlin, and I don't blame him. Boy, yeah. I tell you, that. After all that's going on here, not just today, but in recent weeks, but especially here today, boy, who can blame him for wanting to get somebody in here, can get it all stopped and straightened out.
Absolutely, Dave. It just has gotten to the point with Dundee and Landell, and Dundee's the ringleader of the thing, where
absolutely
something has got to be done. I hate not to be calling the match the way we should. The Fantastics are taking care of business in there, but it is very difficult when you see a friend of 20 years like Jerry Jarrett is of mine to come out here and be in a position where he feels like he can't defend his son because he's going against two knuckleheads up there that do that. And the lowlife don't have any more class than to go for a man's only good eye. He's already lost the sight out of one eye and start to do that. They beat up on a kid like that. Tommy got, you can see what's happening. Go ahead, Dave.
All right. Yeah, I agree with you 100%. It's ridiculous. Bobby Fulton drops down on Tony Falk. Tony Falk looking toward the corner. He's a long way out of that corner, though. Shoulder bump by Bobby Fulton. Down to the mat goes Tony Falk. Tony Falk with a very long losing string on championship wrestling. I wouldn't favor him to break that string today either, going against Bobby and Tommy.
No, you're right there.
A little hair pulling by Falk. Well, you're breaking up rules. You can win some matches. Falk using the fist right now. Reversal by Bobby Fulton. Nice move. Fantastic. Really looking good, as always. Boy, these guys are in terrific shape. When they show up at the arena, they are ready to wrestle. They were kind enough, and referee, too, to hold the match briefly here while we talk to Eddie Marlin. Fantastics themselves showing some class in that. Tony Falk being worked on by Tommy Rogers. Rogers puts him into the ropes. Dumps him over the back to Tony Falk. Hit hard. Tommy bars the right arm of Tony Falk. 3 minutes gone in this one. Bobby Fulton taking over. Tony Falk. I think he hit him with a thumb and jabbed his thumb into his throat. Bobby Fulton comes out after him. I don't know what he did, but I think he shouldn't have done it. Falk makes the tag. Keith Eric being hammered by Bobby Fulton. Eric backed into the corner. Tag made, and Tommy Rogers leaps over the rope. Presses Eric down to the mat. This could be it. Counts to two and three. 4 minutes, 3 seconds of action. And there's a high five from Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, as they get the victory here over the team of Keith Eric and a still winless Tony Falk.
All right, well, fans, that was fucking great.
It sure was. I still feel weird about saying it like that.
Yep, so, but that's okay. You know, Dr. Spock, you know, he always never had a problem with Falcons. Just saying. Wow. We like to geek out around here.
Yeah.
I mean, after all, we're on a show dedicated to wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's going to be all geeked out. So, but now it is time for that part of the show called Made in the South, and it is Made in the South because
we take a look at wrestlers of now when they were yesterday wrestlers doing yesterday stuff.
That's right. Well, not necessarily now, but wrestlers that went on to other great things. And,
yeah.
And the wrestler featured in this here segment.
I know this one.
He's been out of the actual in-ring game for a while, but you can catch him on that network. Doing his interviews from somewhere in Texas. And, of course, this is years before he decided to, like, get stone cold and shower everybody with beer. And so, of course, I am talking about none other than Stunning Steve Austin. And this is Stunning Steve. Once again, we are going to go to Memphis.
Oh, yeah. And it's Memphis Day, almost.
Yep. This is Stunning Steve making his USWA debut, taking on Danny Davis. Wrestling fans from back in the day remember Danny Davis from all over the place as well. So, in a way, this could be a double Made in the South. We've had those before.
That is kind of funny, because my name is Steve, and one of my best friends' name is Danny.
There you go. Steve and Danny.
Steve versus Danny. Friend in the South.
Made in the South. So make sure you stay tuned for after this for a very special report from
my brother Kenny.
Yep. And he'll be telling you about VPW, and I believe he has some guests this week.
Mm-hmm.
And they will be doing a little cheaty chat about the show coming up April 8th. But for now, before we get too deep into the VPW, before we get too deep into catching some kind of virus, let's get Made in the South with Stunning Steve Austin versus Danny Davis.
Danny Davis is going to be on his way to the ring here in just a moment, and he's going to be battling Stunning Steve Austin, who is... See if we can get Steve over here. Steve, if you don't mind, Steve and Jeannie is with him. If we can get him over here for just a moment. This man has been named Rookie of the Year by Professional Wrestling Illustrated. That's Jeff Jarrett was named Rookie of the Year some time ago, and you have just been named Rookie of the Year.
Exactly. I am the Rookie of the Year for 1990, and things have been going real well for me and Jeannie. But what I want to talk about, the only reason I am here today, the only reason I am in the Mid-South, is because of that Southern title that Jeff Jarrett's got around his waist. Now, I think Jeff Jarrett is one heck of a wrestler. He's a great athlete. But when you look at Stunning Steve Austin, you see a man with the tools to do it all. I've done a lot in the short time that I've been in the sport, and I want people to start looking at me as being the greatest wrestler ever. And I don't think I'll have any problem getting that belt from Jeff Jarrett.
Well, it's a tough belt to get. It's a tough belt to hold.
Well, let me tell you something. Stunning Steve Austin, he's the greatest. He's awesome. And you're fixing to see him in action right now.
Exactly. So why don't I just start the match right now?
All right.
You like that?
Let's do that. Steve Austin, Stunning Steve, with Genie in his corner. Oh, my goodness. Well, we don't even get the bell rung, and Steve Austin jumps Danny Davis back there. You know, I was trying to figure him out during the interview, and he's got all kind of confidence. Let me tell you, he's a rookie of the year, and he says he wants folks to... Look at this. Danny Davis has got the shoulders down. What's Jamie doing? Jamie's over here talking to Genie. Count of one, two. Nope, you're a little bit late on that one, Jamie.
What's that all about?
I don't know. Danny held those shoulders down for a 15 count. But Jamie had been distracted by Genie back over here.
Well, certainly Genie can be a distraction.
Yeah, Jamie, that's true.
Jamie better keep his head in the ring and referee the match. That's his job.
Exactly. And, of course, Jamie, a youngster and a young referee and a new referee, so he's going to have to learn that. There was some hair pulling there by Steve Austin. Stunning Steve has yanked Danny Davis down to the mat. Danny just told Jamie Dundee, hey, pull my hair. Jamie said, no, I don't think so. He didn't see it. Well, you know, he didn't see it. There's some hair pulling again. That's difficult to see. Yeah, he pulled hair. We could see it from our angle. I guess, in fairness, Jamie was blocked. He could not see that.
He's out of position, though, a lot of times. And I know he's young, but he needs to really work on that. He's out of position on the holes.
Yeah. All right, Danny Davis fired into the ropes.
Nice backslide by Danny.
Down to the mat, the shoulders. And well, Jamie's over here talking to Genie again. Now he sees the shoulders down. He gets a one count. Boy, Danny Davis got to be getting steamed about this. He's had those shoulders down for about a 20 count now. And Jamie has been distracted both times.
Genie obviously doing her job, but Danny Davis certainly has done his. He has had Stephen Austin down twice.
Yes, he did. And, you know, as big a guy as Austin is a much, much larger wrestler than Danny Davis. You got to take your advantages when you got them against a wrestler the size of Austin.
Austin thinks he's got Danny where he wants him right now. Going right back to him. He's going to put him into the ropes.
Oh, drops Danny over the ropes. Danny bounces back into the ring. Steve Austin feeling mighty good. Genie cheering down here at ringside. Danny just lying there in the ring. There's a cover by Austin. Count of one, two. Oh, Danny wraps both feet around the rope. That stops the count. Austin is unhappy. He said, come on, count one, two, three. And Jamie is telling him he had his feet hooked over the rope. Not just hanging on the ropes. He had them hooked.
Stunning Steve, relentless in his punishment of Danny Davis. Strength on strength. Power slam coming up.
Right out near the middle of the ring. Stunning Steve Austin. Said something to the crowd. I don't know what. Danny hooks him down. His shoulders are down. Again, Jamie's over here talking to Genie. Danny's got him for a count of about 9, 10, 11. No, time he gets there, Steve Austin's able to break out of it. Jamie says, just a one count. That's all.
I can't believe that.
I can't either. Come on, Jamie, that's happened three times. Jamie is just going to have to pay more attention to what's going on in the ring there.
Absolutely right. You've got your first job as referee is to make sure you control the match.
Sure.
Unfortunately, that's not happening.
Not happening at all. Steve Austin. Steve Austin really has been working on Danny Davis since he's been able to gain a bit of an advantage. He has been unrelenting. He has been after it. Danny fired into the turnbuckles. Oh, he moves out of the way. That's a good veteran move. And there's where the rookie shows up. As far as Steve Austin is concerned, he made a mistake. Danny Davis trying to take advantage now. Using the right hand. He's popping him with a fist. He was warned about that by Jamie Dundee. A clothesline. Danny Davis celebrating a little bit. I'm not sure that was a good move. I know Danny felt like doing that, but you need to keep going on your opponent. Boy, he snapped him down there. He's got him covered. And again, Jamie's over here.
He turned his back on that, Dave.
He absolutely turned around instead of going over there and starting the count. And he's over here talking to Genie. And now it looks more like it's not just so much distraction as Jamie just... Here's Eddie Marlin. Eddie Marlin calling for the bell and calling Jamie Dundee out. Let me see if I can get a microphone over here and see what's going on. The match has stopped.
Talk to you till I'm blue in the face. You wasn't ready to referee. It was quite obvious. It is obvious that you're not ready to referee. You wasn't ready to referee.
What do you mean I'm not ready? Welcome back, everybody, to another viral pro wrestling report on Georgia Wrestling History TV. I'm Kenny J, and I know it's been a little while, but we've got a very special guest today. Before I jump into that, I want to talk a little bit about the upcoming Survival Show on April 8th in Thompson, Georgia, and some of the matches that have been announced so far. Of course, we have the main event. It's going to be the Rapture versus the Monster Squad, sure to be a very exciting match. And then, of course, we've got Owen Knight versus Aaron Epic, Effie versus Elijah Evans IV, and today my special guest is Charlie Anarchy. Come on in and talk to me. I am stoked to meet you.
How's it going, man?
I like your art. I like your hat. You've got style, and I dig it. So I want to talk to you a little bit about your success so far with Viral Pro Wrestling. I know that at the last show you took on Sean Legacy, and before that you took on Mr. Oz Knight. Talk to me a little bit about Oz Knight.
Well, you know, both me and Oz Knight both come from Thompson, Georgia.
All right.
Thompson's pretty rich with wrestling history.
Sure.
It's actually kind of funny. Did you know that this year is the 10-year anniversary of me and Oz Knight being indie wrestlers?
Really? I did not.
Yes, it is.
Well, congratulations.
10 years we've been tagging on the road, all the way from Florida up to North Carolina. And I feel like he got a little big for his britches in more way than one, if you know what I mean. Kind of felt like we kind of came to a head there, and unfortunately, I hit him with a kill shot.
I see. So things aren't so smooth between the two of you right now, I guess.
Wouldn't say that.
I see. Well, I know that upcoming at the April 8th show, Survival, we're going to be seeing you in action again against Wade Adams. The
maple syrup guy, right?
Yeah, the good old-fashioned Canadian from way up north. I mean, I'm excited to see that one. I enjoyed seeing him take on Adrian Davis last time. That was quite an interesting match. What do you have to say about Wade? What do you feel about the upcoming match?
Oh, it's been a good at least 4 or 5 years since me and Wade have actually been in the same ring, but pretty excited to see if he's learned anything.
All right.
Charlie Anarchy.
Oh, well, hey there, Wade. How are you?
Hey, yeah.
Welcome to the show.
Oh, yeah. Shake my hand. I guess my invite must have got lost in the mail, huh?
He doesn't have international postage.
Very funny.
I see what you did there.
So, I go to Mr. Hancock and I say, give me a challenge. He gives me Effie Gibbs. Not bad, but it's Effie. I go back, Mr. Hancock, give Wade Adams a challenge. He gives me Adrian Davis. Okay. I'll play along. Ha ha, very funny, Mr. Hancock. Third time. Wade Adams needs a challenge, Mr. Hancock. Who you're going to give me? Charlie Anarchy. I'll be honest. My first thought was to quit Viral Pro Wrestling right there. I was done. I was done putting up with the trash I was being handed.
So you're scared?
I said I was done putting up with the trash.
You know what, Wade Adams?
I'm not scared of trash.
You think so?
But then I said, I can't let this guy down. I can't let the cameraman down. Don't shake your head. I can't let down the fans, the little American children with their American boogers hanging out saying, Mama, where's Canada? Where's Canada? I can't let them down. And then I thought, I can't let Charlie Anarchy down. This opportunity for competition, I'm Wade Adams. I got to give it to him. So on April 8th,
when?
On April 8th.
Okay, I didn't hear you the first two times.
You say you haven't. We haven't been in the ring?
It's been a while.
And it's
been a while.
You're going to see exactly what Wade Adams has learned. Question
sure.
is...
Sure, it's not much.
What have you learned?
You can ask anybody that stepped in the ring with me in the last 2 years. They'll tell you what I've learned.
Oh, yeah?
It's how to take care of foreigners and jabronis like you.
Jabronis. Using the big words, huh?
I mean, it's like three syllables. It might be big up there in Canada, but here it's really not that complicated.
April 8th. Sweetwater Gym, Thompson, Georgia. Here. Get yourself a cup of coffee, because you're going to need it. Get out of my way, cameraman.
Whoa. Okay, then.
That was pretty tough.
Oh, yeah. I got a little goosebumps there. I think I'm going to be okay. Yeah, thank you.
I got you. I'm pretty big. I'm right here. He wasn't going to do anything.
Great. I appreciate it. Thank you. That was a treat, though. That hasn't happened before. That was cool. So, what do you think? I mean, that's going to be...
I'm not one of those guys that really goes out there and talks a bunch of trash and then doesn't deliver.
All right.
So, I'll just tell you this. Any competition's fine with me, and I'm sure he'll get a kill shot just like the other two guys did.
Fantastic. Well, I'm definitely looking forward to that match, and hopefully it'll be as exciting as that little exchange was right there. Thanks for coming on today.
Thanks for having me on the show.
Thanks, Wade, for coming out. Okay, well, we'll see you soon at the show. Alrighty, well, we're going to get back to Stevie and Stoney in the studio. Thanks for checking out this week's VPW Report. We'll see you next time.
Viral Pro Wrestling returns Saturday, April 8th at the Sweetwater Gym in Thompson, Georgia for Survival. Starring Elijah Evans IV, Kiera Hogan, Effie, and making his VPW debut, party manimal Zane Riley. Plus, who will be the most dominant group in the CSRA when the Monster Squad led by Six takes on Anthony Henry and his Rapture? The action hits the mat Saturday, April 8th for Survival. Viral Pro Wrestling, infecting the CSRA.
Thanks, Kenny, for that crazy awesome VPW segment, and thanks to your guest as well. So we're going to move things right along. We're going to show you guys some Avengers.
Well, sort of. Not to be confused with Avengers that wear, like, stars on their chest and shields and stuff like that.
So, like, not Iron Man?
Not Captain America. No.
Well.
What Stevie's talking about is we are going to get into a segment that is very, very close to this show's heart, and that is GCW on GWH TV, also known as Georgia Championship Wrestling on the Georgia Wrestling History Television Network. That's a mouthful.
Yeah, that's one of them old and golden shows.
Old and golden shows.
From yesteryear.
That's right. And just to recap for those of you who may not remember or have never traveled this road with us before, what we do is we go back and we started last year in, I believe, like October, and we started following Georgia Championship Wrestling. We started following October 1979. We are currently in March 1980, and things have been interesting. We've got Russians. So far, Ole Anderson has decided to go from being a bad guy to a good guy. It's just all kinds of crazy things going on.
Yeah.
You know, Tommy Rich, I believe, you know, got like
his
leg broken.
Yeah.
I mean, just crazy, crazy stuff. Harley Race is currently the NWA World Champion. But this week, we've got something a little bit different. We have an interesting promo from one of the most muscular, strongest men in wrestling of all time, one Tony Atlas. And after this interesting promo, Tony Atlas will team up with Kevin Sullivan. And this is Kevin Sullivan before the guy that used to like draw stuff on his forehead and used to, you know, bow down to the Dark Lord of the Underworld, or whoever he bowed down to. That's right. And they will be wrestling...
The Avengers.
The Avengers.
The wrestling kind.
The wrestling adventures. So, should we go check this out?
I think we should. Let's go in the Wayback Machine to some GCWs.
It's my pleasure to have with me right now a gentleman... that I'm very proud to call a friend, Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, a man who has brought himself to a position in life now that you certainly richly deserve, because you've given a lot of dedication, self-sacrifice, and self-discipline to get here.
Well, you know, it ain't very hard to get somewhere. All you got to do is just have the determination, the willpower, and just get in there and give it all you got and work hard. You know, I walk around the streets all day long, and I see people with a lot of good potentials. All they got to do is put their potential in action, and whatever they want out of life would definitely come their way. I was out in Louisiana the other day, and I saw where they had a arm wrestling tournament. I think they should have an arm wrestling tournament here because you got Austin Idol and the Germans, all them talking about how big and strong they is and everything. I was supposed to have been there today, but because of other obligation, I was unable to go down there. So Ken Montel is going down there to take my place in the arm wrestling tournament. And that kind of hurt me because I like getting up there, you know, arm wrestling, kind of fun. And I hope that they have something like that here. You know, the Germans is doing a lot of talking about coming over here, running over people. You know, ain't nobody going to stand by and let nobody bogarm no more. You know, all them guerrilla days is all over, you know. Ain't nobody going for that junk no more. If they want to come here and they want to get down there and get in that ring and boogie, oogie, oogie, then that's the place to do it because I'm going to stand right there and wait for all any competition.
Fair enough. Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, and I'll tell you what we're going to do right now. We're going to have a rare look now at a training regimen that Tony Atlas goes through rigorously all the time. And at the end of the training regimen, you're going to see him bench press over 500 pounds. We'd like to thank the Dirt Band through the release of United Artists for their rendition of Jazz Moon, which will accompany this, and I think you'll see why. It's an outstanding piece of work, so let's take a look at Tony Atlas in action.
Put it up.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team event will be one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from parts unknown, at a combined weight of 450 pounds, the Avengers. The Avengers. Opponents from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing in at 250 pounds, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. His partner from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 230 pounds, Kevin Sullivan.
Kevin Sullivan and Tony Atlas, Mr. USA, going up against the masked Avengers. May I just point out that what you saw just a couple of moments ago is typical of what Tony Atlas does week after week after week after week to keep himself in condition. And as he says, if you have the self-discipline, then you too can accomplish a lot of things. Atlas makes the tag, comes in with the hammerlock. I'm one of the Avengers. Tony Atlas, good clean break, steps back. Collar and elbow once again. The Avenger getting the side headlock. Comes off the ropes. Atlas caught with a shoulder smash. Dropped to the canvas. Atlas caught again. Atlas caught him coming in that time. Beautiful full body slam. Into a full arm drag and twist. The tag is made. The second Avenger moves in. And it is Atlas making the tag with Kevin Sullivan. Sullivan, known as the Boston Battler. Sullivan dropped with a shoulder smash. That time Sullivan had him high. Good arm drag, takedown again. They point up something to you about Kevin Sullivan. Every time he steps in the ring, he's almost assured of the fact that the opponent that he's facing is going to be taller. Sullivan is not an exceptionally tall man, but he's exceptionally big in the heart. This man has a great fighting heart, great speed, great agility, and this, of course, has to make for a lot of difference. As the phrase has been said so many times, it's not the size of the man in the fight, but the size of the fight in the man that counts. And Kevin Sullivan certainly typifies that very situation. Atlas, we just saw a bench press over 500 pounds. Now pressing that tremendous strength on the Avenger. Makes the tag with Kevin Sullivan. Sullivan moves in. The Avenger back on his feet and Sullivan continued to try and dominate the situation. A good fireman carry takedown. Tag is made. Tony Atlas back into the ring. The second Avenger moving in now. And the Avenger moving well against Sullivan, giving Sullivan a hard way to go here. Sullivan staggered, caught again. Sullivan tries to make it over, does make it over, makes the tag with Tony Atlas. Mr. USA moves in once again. Atlas presses him above his head into a full body slam. The second Avenger comes in, and it is Tony Atlas catching him, and now Kevin Sullivan, and we've got a four-way free-for-all going. High backdrop. Tony Atlas, cross body block. Count of three. The count of three. Beautiful cross body block. Well executed by Tony Atlas, that put the Avenger down for that count of three, and let me take just a moment or two. I'll let these fellows get their breath a little bit, but may I just say, gentlemen, a dynamic tag team combination.
Thank you very much, Gordon. It's very nice to have a mountain on your side, you know. I'd rather have it on my side than against it. I think everybody in the world who watches television has to be impressed what this man just did, 500 pounds. That's more than people lift in a lifetime. He just lifted it one chance. I'm very proud to have this man as my partner. That's all I can say.
Thank you very much. You know, in professional wrestling, it's good to be strong, but you could be big and you could be strong, and you don't know what to do with it. It ain't even no use having it. Just like anything else, if you got it, you got to know how to use it. If you don't know how to use it, you might as well give it to somebody else.
Well, that's an interesting observation.
Gordon, I'd like to say something. You know, we've had Russians on here, and we've had the Germans, and they're talking about they're going to take the money out of this country. Well, I'm from the north, and Tony's from the south. I'm white, Tony's black, and this is what I got to say. Just what I said last week. Americans are sticking together, whether they're white, black, red, green, north, south, east, or west. We're sticking together.
All right. Well, we are back now from our GCW segment. Was that not fun?
Oh, man, it was.
Oh, man. So, I mean,
it's like I was really there.
I mean, sure, the Avengers didn't have Captain America or Iron Man on their side, but I thought they did a pretty decent job of...
And there's Avengers that don't have powers. I mean, you know, that's all cool. They're still awesome. So, the wrestling kind, I mean, they can be cool, too.
That's right. That's right.
And they cool were. Stuff.
So, now we are going to shimmy into a segment that he really, really likes, so I'm going to let him tell you what segment we're going into.
Oh, man, it's time for the main event.
The main event. Eventually, we're going to create a main event dance or something like that.
Probably.
I don't know. So, but this event comes from way back when. Wait.
Hang on a second. Isn't this the one that's like the bloodbath one in Nashville?
It's the bloodbath.
That's what we were talking about.
Right, from Nashville Fairgrounds Arena.
Man,
classic wrestling.
Blood on the fairgrounds floor.
That's right.
Dance floor. Fair.
So, and of course, once again, we're in Tennessee. So, of course, you know, you can't, like, have a whole bunch of matches from Tennessee and not have at least one include the King Jerry Lawler. So, and he is taking on the bloody good Robert Fuller.
So, who's full of blood to lose.
So, that's right. So, Fairgrounds, two great wrestlers, and there will be a lot of
blood
outdoors. Can you just imagine? The kiddies are like eating their cotton candy. They've ridden on some farm animals. That's what the fair is kind of like.
Yeah.
Eating some barbecue, and then finally it's
the kind of thing that goes, and you stick to the wall, and then you get off, and you're like,
So now it's the time of the day where they're sitting there eating their cotton candy and their popcorn.
Corn dog.
And they're going to have good family time. And for this family hour, there's going to be a lot of
blood.
That's right. So let's go to our main event. This is in Nashville Fairgrounds Arena. Robert Fuller. The King Jerry Lawler. Didn't get no better than that. So grab your popcorn, sit down, relax.
But don't get any blood in your mouth.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we join this match here in progress in Nashville, Tennessee, the Nashville Arena. A big match between Robert Fuller, the challenger, who is going up against Jerry Lawler, the Southern Heavyweight Champion. This has been an exciting match, a wild match. Both men going at it now for approximately 12 minutes. Nip and tuck. And I would call the match even about this point. Jerry Lawler now with a headlock, shot into the ropes, is caught with an arm drag. And Robert Fuller with a fantastic move winds up with an arm bar on Jerry Lawler. And Fuller now in command of the match as the heavyweight champion in trouble. Pulls at the hair, tugs. Robert Fuller on the bottom now. Lawler shoots a punch into the chin of Fuller. Picks him up, headlocks, another short punch. And the champion thrown into the ropes. Again with an arm drag. Brought down and brought down hard. And Fuller once again in command with an arm bar on the champion, Jerry Lawler. This is Len Rossi at ringside here at the Nashville Fairgrounds Arena. before a beautiful crowd, a very responsive crowd. And Lawler, trying to gain the advantage, turns Fuller over, winds up with a chokehold as referee Tom Sloan orders the break. Lawler does so, but moves right back in, picks Fuller up, headlocks him, shoots a six-inch punch into the neck of the challenger. Fuller staggered now, down on one knee, as Lawler has an object in his hand that appears to be a chain. He throws a big haymaker, and Fuller hits the deck, and it is hard and staggered and slowly trying to regain his feet now. Lawler continues stalking his man, throws another punch. Robert Fuller on the deck as Lawler, once again in command, trying to hang on to his title, pounds away at Robert Fuller. Series of punches. Fuller in serious trouble now, staggered, bleeding badly, on his knees as Lawler continues to dish out punishment to the champion, to the challenger rather, and he has been a great challenger. Lawler pounding away. The referee starting his count. Referee orders a break. Lawler steps back, breaks just long enough to not be disqualified, back in on his man. And it looks like Robert Fuller may have to submit, but no, he fights back, shoots a punch from the floor, fairly effective, slows the champion down, a big right hand to the midsection, stops Lawler temporarily, another left, staggers Lawler, another hard right, and Lawler now staggered, fights back, Fuller weakened, is dropped, Lawler picks his man up, Sam Bass with a big boot, and Robert Fuller avoided the blow. Jerry Lawler was hit by his own manager, and Fuller slowly now regaining his strength, takes the advantage, a big right hand punch, hits Lawler, hauled across the ring into the turnbuckle, and Fuller now pounding away, retaliating, whips Lawler across the ring, staggers the champion, a big knee drops, picks Lawler up high and drops him hard, and this could be the pin, a two count, one more would have given Fuller the title. Lawler is picked up, whipped into the ropes, met with a back body drop, and he has once again hit the deck as Fuller once again gets the count, but only the two count. Of course, three is required. A suplex by Robert Fuller. A beautiful move and an effective move. I believe this is the pin. Once again, a two count. And Lawler now, trying to hang on to his title, is met with another suplex. And this has got to be it. But Bass did distract Robert Fuller. And Lawler has met Bass in the neutral corner, pounding away at Sam Bass. Jerry Lawler wraps a chain around his head. Once again, misses Robert Fuller, hits his manager, and Fuller now takes the object from Jerry Lawler, and Fuller now sends the champion reeling to the mat. Winds up with a big punch, connects solid on the forehead, has opened a cut on the champion's head, and the champion now in trouble. The champion now bleeding, both men bleeding, both men trying to win this match, and I mean win it, because they are going all out. I cannot believe I've seen it, I am seeing it, but both men toe-to-toe, fighting away, about knocked out on her feet. Fuller seems to be the stronger of the two. Headlocks Lawler, shoots a right hand punch, a big loop and hook, and Bass into the ring now. Sam Bass in on Fuller. Staggers Fuller, slows down Fuller's attack. Lawler takes advantage of this opportunity, pounds away at Robert Fuller. Both men on the mat, Fuller on the bottom, receiving the punishment. And Lawler, the champion, is weakened. The blows, not quite as effective as they were earlier, but still doing damage. And I mean, some damage has been done to both men. Tommy Sloan trying to stop it. A spectator. No, Dennis Hall has hit the ring. Jimmy Kent into the ring. Fuller, Bass on the floor. Jerry Lawler has collapsed on the floor of the arena. A very weakened champion. A somewhat subdued champion. But is he still champion? We will find out. We will get the official decision. We will get the official decision in just a moment. Lawler back into the ring. Both men get at each other now. Fuller pounding away, working on Bass. Punches. Oh my goodness. Jerry Lawler headed back to the dressing room. Cut very badly. Has left the arena, headed back for the dressing room. Robert Fuller put up a fantastic battle. Both men desperately after that title. Lawler, of course, I believe the official decision, the match has been stopped by the referee. We'll be back. The match has been stopped. The official decision, the match is declared a no contest. Both men disqualified. Jerry Lawler still maintains his title, and we'll be back with more action after this brief pause.
All right, fans. Well, dude, that was bloody good.
Almost as bloody as one of them new Mortal Kombat games. Yeah. Like, the old ones are bloody, but you look at them new ones.
Yep, that's kind of like the way I ordered my steak. Yep. Just throw it in, about count to five, and flip it over.
Yeah, see, I want it done just enough that Hank Hill isn't like, you need to leave my house. So. Yeah. So,
or, you know, some wrestlers like to just throw it down and count to three and then flip it over.
If they can get past two.
Yep, so we can get past two! So, all right, well, thank you guys once again for tuning in.
Yeah.
And tune in every week. We usually go live, if you look closely, sometimes late Sunday, but always on Monday on the GWH website. And, of course, we have a Facebook. Come like us. Want to remind you guys again, not only on April 8th will there be the VPW event in Thompson, Georgia, but just in a few more days, on the 25th, right?
Yeah.
At Christenberry Field is the Legends of Wrestling in Augusta, Georgia. And you can go to, I believe, was it Kix99?
Kix99.com.
Yep. Get your tickets. There's all kinds of packages and stuff. And meet some of your favorite wrestlers. And we know for sure the Rock and Roll Express. And you know, the this year's Hall of Fame for up there keeps building and building and building. And they keep adding all these great wrestlers that we loved back in the South. So DDP. DDP
yoga now.
Yeah, DDP yoga in the house. Going to be in the Hall of Fame. So I want to congratulate all those people. Kurt Angle, yeah. A lot of people, a lot of great wrestlers.
Congratulations.
So, congrats. So tune in next week and we will bring you, we'll be bringing you some wrestling from Mid-South from 1985, as well as some interesting stuff. How about some early Matt and Jeff Hardy. It's going to be great stuff. And we are going to bring you a main event like no other, which will revisit WCW, but we'll do it in Charlotte later. So stay tuned. All kinds of great stuff.
My mind's already blown.
Yeah, so. All right, so you want to take us out?
I'm Stevie Jay. This is Stoney. And we'll see you next week on the show.